Welcome back to TECHMIMIC, where you can simply view, imitate, replicate, and get on with your day. If there is a specific issue for which you would like to see a video, please leave a comment. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to configure wireless networking on FreeBSD. I will test this with two devices, one wireless USB adapter, the tplink TLWN821N, and the PCI card, the tplink TLWN781ND. Both are cheap and cheerful cards with a generic chipset. Let's start on a fresh FreeBSD system with the USB wireless adapter still disconnected. At the moment, there is no X Windows or desktop manager installed on the system. Later in the video, I will show some graphical utilities. On this motherboard, there is a built-in Ethernet card, so I have unplugged any cables for a proper test. If you do like to install a desktop manager on your FreeBSD installation, for example, XFCE, KDE, GNOME, Cinnamon, I will leave a couple of links in the video description to some other videos for your convenience. List the current files that are dynamically linked into the kernel with the command kld-stat. There is nothing that appears to be related to networking. At this point, connect the wireless USB adapter to a USB port. There is a good chance that FreeBSD informs you that it has found the card, and because this is such a generic chipset, it will be detected automatically and loaded, like you can see on the screen now. Just hit enter if needed to get the prompt back. Check again with kld-stat. Indeed, if_rtwn_usb.ko and rtwn.ko were dynamically loaded. RTWN is the realtek IEEE 802.11 wireless network driver, supporting various realtek chipsets and programming APIs. For example, RTL8192C, RTL9921A, and more. If you would like more information about RTWN, open the man page with the command man RTWN. Exit the man page by typing Q. Type usbconfig and check if the device is visible. It is indeed. The TLWN821N is using the Realtek 8192 chipset that is supported by RTWN. Now that we know that the device is recognized by the system, we are ready to start configuring the Wi-Fi configuration. Type sysctl-n net.wlan.devices. Take note of how your card is listed here, because we need this later. In this case, the value is RTWN0. Now type ifconfig to see if there is a Wi-Fi card listed. There is none, only the onboard Ethernet port and the loopback adapter are listed. Type the command ifconfig wlan create wlan dev RTWN0. This should have added wlan0 to ifconfig. Type ifconfig again. wlan0 is now visible. In my experience, the card needs some minutes to initialize, so give it some time before you continue to the next step. Now to scan and display the list of available Wi-Fi networks, type ifconfig wlan0 up list. There are a couple of SSIDs or wireless LANs listed. I am going to assume the network you want to connect to is broadcasting its SSID, and we are acquiring a TCP/IP address via DHCP. At this point, the USB wireless network adapter is clearly initialized and functional. The last step is to actually connect to a Wi-Fi network. For this, we need to edit a couple of files. The first is etc/rc.conf. Let me show you the contents. Use any editor of your choice and add the two lines wlans_rtwn0=wlan0 and ifconfig_wlan0= WPA sync DHCP. By default, the system will start the WPA connection and then request an IP address, but it doesn't wait for the DHCP process to finish before moving on. By using WA sync DHCP, the system is forced to wait until the DHCP client is finished. For me, that sequence works well, but just replace it with the default, which is WPA DHCP, if that is what you prefer. The next file is bootloader.conf. Again, use your favorite editor and add the following lines. IF underscore RTWN0 underscore load equals yes. And then there are three additional lines. In my testing on different wireless networks, for example, my Wi-Fi at home, a phone hotspot, a public Wi-Fi at a coffee shop, I have noticed that I ran into problems with several different encryption methods. For some, the highlighted three lines might be overkill, and you can leave some of them out, of course, but to be sure, I have added WEP, CCMP, and TKLP lines to my bootloader. In this way, it doesn't matter what is the configured encryption type of the wireless network, and I shouldn't run into issues. WLAN underscore WEP underscore load equals yes. WLAN underscore CCMP underscore load equals yes. WLAN underscore TKLP underscore load equals yes. The final step is to specify the SSID and password of the network we want to connect to. For this, we need to edit the file etc WPA underscore supplicant. If the file doesn't exist, just create it. Again, use your favorite editor. Follow the exact format as is displayed on the screen now. I am showing you two different examples. The first one is my home network and the second one is my mobile phone's hotspot. You can add multiple or just one network, and you can, if you want, assign them a priority as well. Replace SSID with your SSID, PSK with your password. The value for key underscore MGMT I left at WPA-PSK. Now you can reboot the machine to make sure it is all working, or it might be sufficient to just restart networking with the command service netif restart. But I just went ahead and restarted the system. After I give the system a minute or so, the Wi-Fi is connected. Check the IP address received with the command ifconfig wlan0. To test if DNS is working, just ping a random address. A final tip for administering Wi-Fi networks from the command line could be bsdconfig. Type bsdconfig Wi-Fi to go straight into the wireless networking section of bsdconfig, where you can change settings, rescan the available Wi-Fi networks, and much more. Now for the PCI Wi-Fi card. The procedure is just the same. Simply replace USB config with the command pciconf -lv pipe grep -a1 -b3 network. Because we are now dealing with a PCI card instead of a USB device. The RTWN0 card is listed with chipset 8188E, and the KLD stat commands show the PCI version of RTWN dynamically linked to the kernel. The main page of RTWN learns us again that the 8188E chipset is supported. Just follow the same steps to configure your wireless network. That's it for networking from the command line interface. For example, I can now log in to this FreeBSD box via SSH. As mentioned before, if you run a desktop manager, there are some graphical tools. In this example, I will show this for XFCE, but simply adjust accordingly. Links will be in the description of the video, as always. The first utility is networkmgr, written as networkmgr. To install, type pkg install networkmgr and start with the command networkmgr. It will connect to the already configured Wi-Fi network, and it behaves exactly as you would expect from a network manager in a graphical user interface. Just have a look for yourself. Going forward, if you restart your machine, it will start automatically when XFCE is started and will connect to the Wi-Fi network. The second utility is Wi-Fi Networks Manager, written as wifimgr. To install, type pkg install wifimgr. Find it in the menu structure. It lists the configured networks and I can easily switch between them. Both utilities will have some overlap, but also differences. Just see what utility works best for you, or maybe even both. By now, you will have seen that there are many different ways to configure wireless networking in FreeBSD, straight from the command line interface through the use of commands, through bsdconfig, or through graphical utilities in the desktop manager. That's it. Hope it helped, and if it did, please like the video and keep it up. Until next time, bye!